Las Vegas and G4's coverage of the 6th Annual Interactive Achievement Awards. I'm Diane Mizota.
And I'm Patrick Clark. We're at the Hard Rock Hotel and Casino, which is the site of this year's awards. There are 30 categories and close to 200 nominees, so it's anybody's guess as to who will actually win.
The tension is starting to build as people start to file into the theater. Let's see if we can get some predictions from tonight's attendees on who they think will be going home happy.
Metroid Prime, all the way. It really is an accessible game that can be enjoyed by the hardcore and the mass market alike.
I want to see Animal Crossing win. My kids are totally addicted to that thing.
Dad, don't ever make a stop.
I would love my game. I would love going this forever to win, of course.
There is one game that comes to everyone's lips is probably GTA Vice City.
I have to admit it, Ted Price is going to kill me as President Insomniac, but Grand Theft Auto Vice City took more of my time this year than just about any other game.
I think that you always have to look at who's outselling everybody by a wide margin and normally figure that's a game everybody who is in the voting group has played. So for that reason, you always have to look at GTA Vice City and think that gives them some advantage.
Hedging my bets, so yeah, they're all fantastic games, or they wouldn't be nominated, so yeah, good luck to the winners.
Oh, my game of the year pick, I mean, who wants to hear that, really? Let's just see what happens, how about that?
The Academy of Interactive Arts and Sciences is giving out 30 awards tonight, ranging from Outstanding Achievement in Art Direction to the coveted Game of the Year. From the guys who are chained to their desk writing code to the lucky producers who take all the credit, there's an award for every aspect of creating a game. But we've only got an hour to bring you the whole experience, so let's take a look at some of tonight's winners.
Who's hungry for awards? Tonight we're going to honor outstanding achievement in an industry that is... Well, no, I'd say it's an art form.
The look of the game is the icing on the cake. It's more like the girl inside the cake.
Outstanding achievement in animation. Kingdom Hearts. Sly Cooper and the Thievius Raccoonus. Final Fantasy X. Ratchet & Clank. The Mark of Kree.
The award goes to Sly Cooper and the Thievius Raccoonus.
Thank you very much for all your votes. We were not expecting this, so we're pretty surprised.
Damn. All right, now.
Outstanding achievement in character or story. Eternal Darkness, Sanity's Requiem. Grand Theft Auto, Vice City. Kingdom Hearts. The Mark of Creed. Siberia.
And the award goes to... Eternal Darkness, Sanity's Requiem.
I'd like to thank the Nintendo family. It's overwhelming. Thank you very much.
Be recognized by your peers like this is fantastic.
Vince Neil, you like playing role-playing games, huh?
Yeah, right.
Yeah. you can keep going. Yeah. No, we're not doing that one.
Outstanding achievement in original music composition. Medal of Honor Frontline. Metroid Prime. The Elder Scrolls 3 Morrowind. Rygar, The Legendary Adventure. Warcraft 3 Reign of Chaos.
The award goes to Medal of Honor Frontline.
I want to thank DreamWorks for starting it, EA for picking up the ball and running with it.
It feels great. It's always great, this kind of a thing, you know?
Outstanding achievement in game design. Animal Crossing. Battlefield 1942. Metroid Prime. Neverwinter Nights. Warcraft 3, Reign of Chaos.
And the award goes to... Animal Crossing.
I would like to accept this award as a producer, and I would like to say on behalf of Mr. Tezuka, and Mr. Nogami, and Mr. Eguchi, thank you very much.
Along with awards for video game design, the AIAS also honors one developer who is at the top of the heap. Someone who has consistently proven that he is worthy of being inducted into the AIAS Hall of Fame. This year's honoree has created some of the most innovative games we've ever seen. From the arcade classic Hang On to the console epic known as Shenmue, Yu Suzuki has broken new ground in all 16 of his titles. And he's been leading the industry for 20 years. So it seems only fitting that he's this year's recipient of the Hall of Fame Award.
Hall of Fame Award. Yu Suzuki.
Yu Suzuki really was kind of like the Michelangelo of the video game industry. He's a philosopher, he's an artist, he's a mathematician.
People told me that I was different from other children. I love making things and drawing things too. I love playing with clay and drawing pictures.
He had this incredible vision that the arcade industry is going to become more than just tabletop games. Hang On is a good example of Yu Suzuki's idea of realism. What would it feel like to really be a motorcycle rider if you'd never ridden a motorcycle before? Virtua Fighter was a blueprint for a lot of companies on how to make a 3D game. In 1998, the Virtua Fighter series was accepted by the Smithsonian for the Computer World Smithsonian Award. All of the Virtua Fighter machines are displayed in Smithsonian for everybody to look at from now until the end of time, and that's a huge accomplishment for Yu Suzuki in video games.
This was the first game that he created which had actual human characters with moving joints and real and interactive fighting. There has never been another game where we knew that it was going to succeed even before we completed making the game. The reason why it's Shenmue so special is that it realized something no one had ever done before.
I think Shenmue is a culmination of everything that he's done. He's a kind of a fun-loving guy. He likes, sports cars. He likes, doing a lot of sports activities. He's a musician. He paints. And so he believed in creating an experience for people.
His whole career has been one hit after another. And I know there's another hit just waiting to happen.
I'm here with Bruce Shelley, who is among those honoring the newest Hall of Fame member, Yu Suzuki. What do you think has been Suzuki-san's biggest contribution to the industry?
Well, I think he sort of invented the virtual fighting games, and he did a lot of amazing work with arcade games.
What is your personal favorite Suzuki title?
I think the Virtual Fighters games are sort of quick, fast entertainment. I don't do very well at it, but it's kind of fun to try the special kicks.
Yu Suzuki isn't the only big winner at this year's Interactive Achievement Awards. Stay with us because when we come back, we'll bring you the biggest winners, including the Game of the Year.